Joining us on the show today is Marc Chandler. He's the Global Head of Currency Strategy at Brown Brothers Harriman and one of the most widely respected and quoted currency experts today. And Marc, you wrote the book in 2009, just as the financial crisis was fresh in most people's minds, thinking that the US dollar was going to tank, that the American economy was doomed. And you wrote Making Sense of the Dollar, Exposing Dangerous Myths About Trade and Foreign Exchange. And there was 10 of them that you tackled in your book, not just about the US dollar, but also about America's place in the world, the nature of capitalism, globalism, a lot of these big picture topics that many people are constantly discussing in the financial news and elsewhere. Out of the 10 that you mention, which of them do you think still has the greatest mythological power in most minds today?
I suspect that the myth that probably people still believe, despite my best efforts, that the U.S. trade deficit is a sign of U.S. weakness. As a sign of that the dollar is overvalued. And as you know, the U.S. continues to run a trade deficit. And if anything, the dollar has gotten quite strong in the last year or so. And I think the problem is that a lot of us know who Adam Smith is, but very few of us have really read Adam Smith. And Adam Smith is really critiquing these French, what they called physiocrats, mercantilists, who thought that the way a country becomes wealthy is by running a trade surplus, accumulating at that time gold. And I think that the situation has become so much more complicated because of globalization. So that I would say that I would ask, how do U.S. companies service foreign demand? And the typical answer is by exporting. But I can tell you that that is not only not true, but it hasn't been true since before I was born, and I'm 55 years old. And it's not a question, it's not like football, a game of inches. We're talking about miles. Here's what it looks like to me. The U.S. is a large exporter. We're the world's third largest exporter, behind China, Germany, and then the U.S. But that is not the way the U.S. services foreign demand. U.S. companies service foreign demand by building locally and selling locally. Here's what it looks like. If you would look at the sales by the majority-owned affiliates of U.S. companies, their local sales are more than four times larger than the U.S. exports. What happens, I think, is for various historic reasons, the U.S. has pursued a direct investment strategy. Build factories overseas to service demand overseas. And part of the reason is that the dollar was very overvalued in after World War II and through the 60s and most of the 70s. Part of the reason as well is that countries use protectionism. And one way to avoid protectionism or get around it is to build inside those protectionist walls.
Yeah, that's one of the things that is really borne out in your book is just the sheer number of really good facts, I think, that, you know, we all have to take into account. And specifically when we think about the future of the dollar. And the sixth myth that you discuss is the dollar's privileged place in the world is lost. That was a prevailing myth in 2009. It continued for years going forward. And in your book, you argue that not only was that a myth, but that the dollar was likely to strengthen and maintain its place in the world for some time. Clearly, we have seen the dollar strengthen dramatically since I think it bottomed in 2011. And then we saw that sharp run up in 2014. So, you know, it's been 7 years since you've written that book in 2009. Has anything changed in terms of the dollar's place in the world as you see it?
Hi, everybody. John Loeffler here. You know, you've just been listening to a free preview of the Financial Sense Insider Premium Edition. Do you need help making sense of the market? I mean, you've heard the old adage, it's a jungle out there. Well, you know, you can join our premium weekday service and you'll gain access to leading experts, analysts, and market technicians on what's driving the markets, the economy, and your future. You can get all of that by subscribing today at financialsense.com. That's Financial Sense, S-E-N-S-E, like you're trying to make sense of something, .com. And click subscribe to join our premium weekday service. You won't regret it.